Hello friends, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we'll be attempting to sketch a portrait of former United States President Mr. Barack Hussein Obama. Well, this is a reference photo from which we'll be drawing the portrait. As always, I love to observe my reference photograph first, give it some time. On observation at first glance, the first thing that comes into our mind is the left side of the photograph is in light and the right side is in dark. Then the important highlighting features in this picture are the hair, and for me I feel the lips, the angulation of the lips. Also the peculiar skin texture, a little bit of rough skin texture if can be shown, which will give a good hyper-realistic effect to the sketch. So like every time, I like to start my sketch from the eyes. When I'm done with the eyes, I get an idea whether I'm going right. Minor changes in the eye can change the effect of the entire portrait. The hair here looks quite complicated, but to be honest, it is actually pretty easy as compared to the other portraits we have done. What basically I've done is I've just applied a base layer of 7B pencil, and on top of that with an 8B dark Staedtler pencil, I have just drawn crisscross small hair strokes. Just one small thing to keep in mind here is to slightly observe the areas of hair which are dense, as in very dark patches, and some other areas where there is less amount of hair. Now I would like to concentrate a little bit on the skin texture here. A little bit in detail we'll try to discuss. Especially this area which I'm doing is in light, and the light is reflecting from the cheeks. So if that can be shown, it will give a more natural appearance. An important thing to keep in mind here is the direction of the creases which you are going to give. The basic direction here is that the creases, they start from under the eye and they move towards the outer side of the face. Then they curl inside and end at the crease which is just besides your nose. So that direction should be slightly followed and should be shown in the portrait. So again, we have to build this area in layers. My favorite pencil for a base layer is 7B. So I have given a 7B, light pressure 7B base layer. Then I love my mechanical pencil to show the creases. Just following the direction of creases, as I told you, with my mechanical pencil, I am slightly giving small lines, irregular lines following the direction. These lines should be optimally light. They shouldn't be so dark that they are easily visible. Also, they shouldn't be so light that they are not visible at all. It should be slightly visible when you look at it. Since here I have zoomed into the photograph, they might look a little more over exaggerated. But in when you look at the portrait from a distance, they look pretty realistic. Now once I am done with the creases with the mechanical pencil, I slightly blend them with a paper stump. Not very much, just slightly blending them. Then a very important thing which has to be done is using a very sharp eraser. In this case I have used a circular headed Tombow Mono eraser. In between the creases what you have drawn, you have to slightly rub those areas. So that gives an appearance of elevation and depression, and that it simulates a crease on your face. Also on the cheek just besides the nose, as light is reflecting, the creases would be more prominent as compared to the other part of the cheek. So here what I've done is I have used a white gel pen in certain areas in a circular pattern in between the creases, and slightly over exaggerated that area. So it appears as if light is reflecting from that part. So this is how it looks after completion of that part. Of course, minor changes and slight finishing will be done towards the end. So I basically wanted to highlight this skin texture part in this particular portrait. Rest of the portrait I have just followed basic principles of portrait making. Also another thing which is important in this portrait is the direction of the lips. I had made it wrong initially, but then I corrected the the thickness of the lips. Just the observation that the right side of the lip is slightly more elongated as compared to the left side. It gives a peculiar smile, which is a characteristic of this portrait. Well, following these principles and keeping these things in mind, I finally finished my portrait. I hope you like the final work. If you have liked this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Share it with your friends and your family. Also, do let me know in the comment section if any suggestions on any specific tutorials you need to know. Last but not the least, please do subscribe our channel. Catch you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.